Hello, hello, it's Lance. Here on the Fab Four Archivist channel, we dig into the stories that have made the Beatles the biggest band in the world. And on most Fridays, we dig into some Beatles news. After last week's head rush of Beatles headlines, we've got one major story and one minor story this week. The minor one is an important heads up. With all the celebrations of the 50th anniversary of Abbey Road last week, you may have missed the big specials about the band on BBC Radio and Sirius XM. As Aisha commented here on last week's news video, many of these shows are available online with varying expiration dates. I highly recommend the two-hour, two-part The Abbey Road story.
It's BBC Radio 2 Beatles.
Celebrating the Fab Four.
It features the story of the record, obviously, and many cuts from the new box set. Check out the description for a link to listen. The bigger story, though, is some fun news for all of us. Last week's re-release of Abbey Road has put the Beatles on the top of the UK album charts yet again. The Beatles have not only topped the album's sales, but they also broke a record, their own. Abbey Road is now the record holder when it comes to the longest gap between a turn at number one. And in this case, it was just a few days shy of 50 years. The record they broke was when a similar re-release situation put Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band at the top spot. Abbey Road beat Pepper by 127 days. I'd be remiss to not note that the previous number one album in the UK was the newest by Liam Gallagher, formerly of Oasis. Both living Beatles commented on their achievement, with Paul reminding us that Abbey Road is a bloody cool album, and Ringo saying, "How cool is that?" and then adding a bunch of pieces and loves. As for the top spot in the US, because of the different way releases happen and sales are calculated here, we'll know in a few days. But here's what the current top 10 looks like, with Post Malone at number one. And yes, all you baby boomers, I'm aware that you don't know who most of these artists are. If it makes you feel any better, I'm 25 years younger than a lot of you, and I only recognize about half. Interestingly, Abbey Road was already on the top 200 chart, sitting at number 71, a few spots below the Beatles 1 compilation. Not too bad for a 50-year-old record. There won't be a news episode next week. It's fall break around these parts, and I'll be in the mountains. But make sure you subscribe to this channel if you're not already, because there's a big story video coming soon. All right, thank you so much for watching. If you want to see previous episodes of Beatles News, check out these videos.